اهلا بكم. My talk today will be about the plain X-ray findings in small bowel obstruction. In the last capsule, we mentioned that there are a lot of intrinsic, extrinsic, and intraluminal causes of small bowel obstruction, and the most common cause is fibrous adhesions in about 75% of cases, followed by hernia, either internal hernia or external hernia, in about 10% of cases. In any suspected case of bowel obstruction, either small bowel or large bowel, what are the radiological investigations you have to start with? We have to start with chest X-ray, erect position, followed by supine abdominal X-ray, followed by erect abdominal X-ray, followed by CT abdomen. Why we have to start with erect chest X-ray? This is in order to appreciate any evidence of pneumoperitoneum if bowel perforation is happened due to the intestinal obstruction. Erect chest X-ray is very sensitive in detection of pneumoperitoneum. It can detect up to 1 milliliter of free intraperitoneal air, but you have to keep the patient in erect position for at least 10 minutes before taking the exposure in order to give enough time for any small amount of free air to rise up under surface of the cupula of the diaphragm, as you see in this image and also in this image. If the patient cannot stand in erect position, we can do for him lateral decubitus abdominal X-ray, as you see, and the patient lies on his side and the X-ray pass through the body from front to the back, as you see here. So if there is any possibility of pneumoperitoneum, it will rise to the upper part of the abdomen and so will be seen on one side of the abdominal X-ray image, as you see here. Coming to supine abdominal X-ray. What are the radiological findings we can detect from supine abdominal radiograph in cases of suspected small bowel obstruction? Number one, dilatation of small bowel loops more than 3 centimeters, which are centrally located, with appreciation of valvular connivance, which are mucosal folds crossing the entire lumen of the dilated bowel loops, as you see in this image and also in this image. What about erect abdominal X-ray? In erect abdominal X-ray, we can appreciate multiple air fluid levels, but the air fluid level has to be more than 2.5 cm in length, in same loop of bowel, but at different heights, as you see in this image. Here, this is erect abdominal radiograph showing multiple air fluid levels. The air fluid level, as you see, greater than 2.5 cm. And the fluid levels of unequal heights in the same dilated loop of a small bowel. In cases of, if the dilated small bowel loops are completely filled with fluid, I mean there is no air inside. Here we cannot appreciate the air fluid levels or estimate the caliber of the dilated bowel because there is no air inside. But here it can give what is known as pseudotumor. This sign seen in cases of gasless abdomen, where small bowel filled with fluid, not air. Here the small bowel gives appearance similar to as the patient has been drinking dilute gastrographine. The abdominal X-ray, as you see, will demonstrate what is looks like soft tissue mass or pseudotumor, as you see in this image. The same patient we did for him upper GI series by oral gastrographine showed the soft tissue mass is actually due to fluid-filled dilated small bowel, as you see in this image. There is marked dilatation of the small bowel loops, centrally located in the mid of the abdomen, with appreciation of the valvular connivance, as you see here. In cases of a small bowel nearly filled with fluid, except for small air bubbles trapped between the folds of the valvular connivance, as you see in this drawing. If the patient imaged in supine position, this trapped air will give a sign known as stretch sign. And if the patient is imaged in erect position, it will give a sign known as string of pearls sign. So stretch sign is due to trapped air in between the valvular connivance, and fluid filled dilated the small bowel lobes in supine position. In abdominal X-ray, as you see here, it appears as slit-like lucences on a background of gasless abdomen, as you see in this image. While string of Peale sign is due to trapped air in between the valvular connivance and fluid-filled dilated small bowel lobes in an erect position, it will be appreciated in the form of nearly gasless abdomen with multiple rounded small lucences arranged beside each other, as you see in this image, and in this image, and also in this image. Don't forget, stretch sign and the string of Peale sign are almost always indicative of small intestinal obstruction. So let us summarize features of a small bowel obstruction on plain X-ray. Dilated central located bowel lobes with appreciation of valvular connivance, multiple air fluid levels if the study is erect. Air fluid level should be more than 2.5 cm in its length. In cases of fluid-filled dilated small bowel lobes, it will give a picture of pseudotumor. In cases of nearly fluid-filled, except for small air bubbles trapped in between the valvular connivance, it will give stretch sign on supine radiograph and the string of Peale sign in erect abdominal radiograph. So this is everything regarding the plain X-ray finding in cases of a small bowel obstruction. Inshallah, in next capsule, we will continue the CT features of small bowel obstruction. Thank you very much.